Hello everyone, welcome to our channel. This video is the continuation part of Karnataka State Syllabus Social Textbook Summary of 8th Standard, and this is about Chapter 3. So, we'll see the content. Chapter name is Ancient Civilization of India. In this video, we'll be covering Indus Valley Civilization or Harappan Civilization. In next video, we'll see about the Vedic age, types of Veda and their life. So here I'll be covering nomad life to stable life, first urbanization, special feature of the cities, town planning, their town life and decline of these towns. First we'll see nomad, how they from nomad they led a settler life, how they became a settler. So in a previous video we saw that in the prehistoric age they were nomads, that is they used to travel from one place to another place in search of food and animals. But here you can see the signs of huts and houses in the Indus Valley civilization, and in Sellar was found in Burza home in Kashmir. Now let's see where did they live, and let's study about the shallow pits. These shallow pits, they were dug in soil and they lived inside these pits, and they had steps which led into these pits, and these pits they provided protection from cold weather and even wild animals. And earthen pots were found inside these shallow pits. Maybe these pots were used for storing different grains and even for cooking purpose. And cooking was done inside and outside depending upon the weather condition. Now let's see what is Mehrangarh. Mehrgarh or Mehrangarh, it's a site near the fertile plain of Bolan Pass leading to Iran, and several things are associated with this Mehrangarh place. So it was the first site where cultivation of barley and wheat crops were found, and these were the first ones to learn. And these were the first ones to learn the rearing of goat and sheep, and it was the first village which was noticed by the archaeologist. And people here, they lived in houses with four or more rooms, and the sites they had fossils of animals and even graves. Peoples and animals, they were buried together. This show that they had domesticated animals or they had pet animals in their home. Next, let's see the first urbanization, that is Harappan site. So this site was discovered about 150 years ago by the engineers while laying the railway lines, and they thought it was as the mound of excellent bricks. So it was found in the Sindhu Valley region of Punjab, which is in present Pakistan. And the what archaeologists did is they did some research and they concluded it as ancient city. Now these cities are said to be 4600 years old. Since Harappa was the first site to be discovered, it is called as the Harappan civilization. So let's see the significance of these cities or special features. So these cities, they had two parts, that is western part, that is called as citadel, and eastern part as lower town. And these walls, they were made of burnt bricks. So western part was narrow and it was an elevated place, and eastern part was wider and it is called as lower town. Now let's see one of the important site or the city, Mohenjo-daro. So it had a famous bath tank, you can see the picture in your right hand side. So these tank, it was built of bricks, and these bricks were used to prevent the seepage of water, and steps was there on either side to go down into the bath tank. And rooms were all around. Maybe these rooms were used for changing purpose, and water was supplied by the well, and used water, whatever was used for bath purpose, it was let out. And maybe the historians, they think that these bath tank may be used by important people on special occasions. Now some other things were also discovered, like fire altars were discovered in Kalibangan. This Kalibangan is in Rajasthan and Lothal is in Gujarat, and Mohenjo-daro also. So fire altars were found in Kalibang and Lothal, and Mohenjo-daro, Harappa and Lothal had constructed systematic granaries. Now let's see how they had planned their town. So lower town, as I had told you, it was wider, it was the place of habitation, and it was constructed in a very methodical manner, and systematically laid out houses, roads and drains can be found in lower town. So how were their houses? Let's see what all features their houses had. So it was either one or two storied. It was built of bricks and had very strong wall. Rooms were all around the courtyard, and there was courtyard inside. The main road, main door, it faced the street, and none of the windows opened into the street. That means they had a private life. They didn't want people to see them through the windows, what activities they are carrying out. So they didn't, that's why they didn't have any windows onto the street. And there were bathrooms in the house. So this show that they gave a lot of importance to hygiene purpose, and even they had well laid drains. Okay. And some houses had wells which supplied water. Now let's see the drainage or the sewage system. So it was neatly laid out. It was made up of bricks and it had stone slabs. The gutter of each house was connected to the main drain outside so that the drainage water was taken from the house onto the main drain outside and then to the place where they want to send these drainage water. And holes were there in the drains to enable cleaning. So these inspection holes were made in the drainage so that they can clean it properly now and then. Okay, we'll see the town life. So they were very artistic because precious stones, metals, beads and seals were found. And people may have used expensive metals, gems and jewelries, and beads, they were used by the common people. And unknown script were found on the seal. So these people, they had a pictorial form of script, which is still now not deciphered. Means historians, they are not able to find out what was there in the script. Okay. Now let's see agriculture and trade. So wheat, barley, pulses and mustard, these were their main crops, and they grew commercial crop like cotton and they weaved cloth. So they knew irrigation because since these civilization were on the banks of rivers like Indus and its tributaries, so they knew irrigation. Humped bull, cow, buffalo, sheep, goat, dog and hen were domesticated, and oxen was used for transport purpose like to carry heavy loads. Let's see about trade. So they had trade relation with rural areas like Balochistan, Saurashtra and the Deccan, and seals were found at Mesopotamia. So Indus Valley seals were found at Mesopotamia. So this show that the Mesopotamia had the trade relation with Indus Valley civilization people. Okay, now let's see the decline of the towns. So what are the reasons for the decline of the towns? So what happened at the later years? The walls of forts were further strengthened. West gate was closed completely, and spacious rooms of Mohenjo-daro became smaller. Okay, they had very spacious rooms which became smaller, and huge building they turned into huts, they became poor. Neither the town planning nor the road planning, which we saw in our previous slides, that houses and roads and drainage was nicely laid out, this was not there after in the later years. And historians, they say some of the natural reasons which might have caused the decline of the towns, like rivers might have dried up, rivers might have changed the course, and flood might have occurred, which destroyed these places. And destruction of forest, maybe for house or agricultural purpose, might have led to the decline of the towns, or these people might have deserted that place and migrated to some other regions. So these were the causes, like assumed causes for the decline of the towns. So that's it in today's video. We learned about one of the important ancient civilization of India, that is the Indus Valley civilization. In our next video, we will learn about the Vedic era, types of Vedas, and how was their life. Okay, if you have liked our video, then give a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed our channel, then please subscribe. Thank you.